Rocky Flats was one of the primary weapons components manufacturing facility.
Rocky Flats manufactured plutonium triggers. They used the plutonium to have a chain reaction that released enough energy to compress the uranium to explode in an atomic bomb.
Our defense during the Cold War could not have been complete without a facility like Rocky Flats. There was none other in the world.
The workforce was very highly motivated for what they did. They really believed that they were contributing to our nation's defense, to the stability of the world, and to ultimately winning the Cold War. History has proved that we did it better than the Soviets did, and essentially they couldn't keep up.
Today, the government of East Germany announced that its borders are open.
The change in the Rocky Flats mission really came from world events. The old Soviet regime was crumbling, and so really that signaled the end of the production mission at Rocky Flats. We've been told very clearly, your mission is cleanup and closure. Figure it out.
Rocky Flats basically, when it started out, had practices of the same as every place else in the world. We've got this stuff we no longer need, let's bury it over there. There were a lot of things that were done that would not be acceptable in today's world by any stretch of the imagination.
The regulatory authority to enforce and penalize increased as our regulatory authority expanded. The cleanup agreement required interaction with the stakeholders. In the case of some of these groups, like the Citizens Advisory Board, I can testify that their involvement did lead to changes and a better cleanup. That allowed the major part of the site, the peripheral operable unit, to be delisted from the national priorities list and to be transferred to the Fish and Wildlife Service to be opened as a wildlife refuge. The central operable unit was also thoroughly investigated. The conclusions were that any contamination, residual contamination, is below levels of health concern for workers at the site. And I've seen it go through this remarkable process to turn it into an asset for the people of Colorado.